What is up, you guys? Welcome Daily Tea. Just saying. What's up? So glad you guys could join my channel. Just saying. My name's Mary. I'm with High Priestess Intuition. Welcome Daily Tea. I did get one message as I was meditating on your energy. Sorry I'm kind of late, but I worked tonight, so I wanted, even though I've been off a couple days, I wanted to fully rest. And so I did. And I feel great. So here we go. Just saying. It's the message was someone is about to get very smart and start collecting evidence. That's what I heard. So for whoever that's for, just saying. That's all I heard. So I don't know what you're collecting evidence on or who you're collecting it on or the legal way is what I heard. The legal way. Okay, that's what I just heard. The legal way. Someone's getting very smart and starting to collect evidence. I heard the legal way. So the legal way, just saying. However the legal way is, obviously not planning hitting cameras in people's homes, just saying. But however that is. Now, if it's your own home and you are like married or committed partner with someone, that's a different story. You know, no, that's a whole different story because that's your home, their home, and you have every right to do that because that's your partner, your significant other. You know, they committed to you. That's different. Now, if you're just going around planting hitting cameras in single people's homes, that's breaking the law. Just saying. But apparently, I heard someone's about to start collecting evidence the legal way. So, okay. So, I'm assuming it's probably a camera in your own home that you pay mortgage or you pay rent for. Or maybe if it's your partner's phone, maybe getting screenshots or something when you're in y'all's home, not a single mother's home with a hidden camera. That's just freaking cray cray. That way, or maybe getting people to send you screenshots or emails of conversations, maybe. You take it how it resonates. But I heard someone's about to start collecting evidence, and they're about to do it the legal way. So, just saying. Evidence. So, apparently they're going to want to take somebody to court. I'm just saying. This is what we got. Don't forget the basics. Time is fluid. Energy is fluid. If it doesn't apply, let it fly. Everyone has free will. Only take the messages that resonate with you. Especially important in all my free journal readings, because these are all free journal readings. But especially important in Daily Tea, because it's a more general pulling of the collective energy. It's a little different than the other readings. It's supposed to resonate 24 to 72 hours out from the time that you view it. However, everyone's on different time and life paths. So just saying. All right, attachment. Oh, and if you think anyone could benefit from these messages, if you wouldn't mind sharing these on your social media, whatever social media platform you use, like Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, IG, Parlay, Mayway, I would appreciate it. Someone's about to catch their significant other with the family member very soon. OMG. Whoa. I heard someone's about to catch their significant other with a family member. With a family member very soon. Catch them with the family member very soon. So, just saying. That sounds like catch them in the act. Like, maybe it's on the kitchen counter. Maybe it's in the bed. Maybe it's on the floor. Maybe it's in the bathroom. I don't know. But, catching them. So, you're catching them doing either it or orally. I'm not trying to be gross or nasty, but I mean, just for real. Real world, 101. Or that's more like 202, but I'm just saying. For real. Attachment. It's about to be on very, very soon. That's what I just heard. It's about to be on very, very soon. So it's about to be on. Donkey Kong. It's about to be on, baby. Like, this person is not playing. No holds, no bars. Whoever this is, Apparently, they're going to start collecting evidence legally. That was specified in here. And someone's about to, I don't know if it's the same person or a different person, about to catch their partner, I heard, with a family member. So I don't know if it's their family member or a family member of the partner's. We've had a lot of incest coming in lately. I mean, Leo's reading, I just did, had incest in it. And about 3 months ago, 2 or 3 months ago, I was picking up incest in there 2 or 3 months ago in the summertime. So, or fall to summertime. So, I'm just saying, ew. And it was a masculine Leo with a female family member in Leo's reading. But you take it how it resonates. Yeah. Someone is ready to legally break free of the drama and nastiness. Okay, I heard someone's about is ready to legally break free from the drama and nastiness. Legally ready to break free. So, legally ready meaning, I'm assuming for who this is resonating, that message resonates with, legally. So, you're married to this person possibly. Because we have the attachment card, or detachment rather, that's what I think of. You're legally married. I mean, because family members, you know, you're not legally binded to those folks, unless you give them like power of attorney or something. But you're not legally binded to those folks, unless it's like a guardianship or something. But there has to be like a huge reason to have a person under guardianship, like a Britney Spears kind of thing. But you know, she had a mental breakdown for like years, and she did a lot of it in public. So that, you know, of course now she's still paying for it 12 years later, and I personally don't think she should be paying for it 12 years later. She's 39 years old. Let the woman have her $57 million or $56 million, whatever ridiculous amount of money she has, that her father basically has control of, and let her have it and move on, because she's doing wonderfully the past 7 or 8 years or so. But that's my personal opinion. But something like that is what I'm trying to say. Unless you give a person power of attorney, or you are under some kind of some kind of guardianship because of some kind of crazy mental breakdown that happens in public, like Britney Spears, then you have no legal connection to family members. That's why I think it's a married partner. But you take it how it resonates. Let's see if I hear anything else. Some are getting wheels changed soon. It's really going to upset some family members. Okay, I heard some are getting wheels changed soon. And it's really going to upset some of their family members. So, what I take from that is maybe a family member was in your wheel, and you're about to change it, and it's about to piss them off. But you know, you have to do what's best for you and your family if you have children. But you have to do what's best for you. Your will is your will. I mean, just saying. I feel guided to still get energy. I need to check a time on the time because I've got to leave at like 2:45. Oh crap, what time is it? 2:16. Someone is about to come down with a severe respiratory illness very, very soon. It's going to take them by surprise, is what I just heard. Someone's about to come down with a severe respiratory illness soon. It's about to take them by surprise. So for how that resonates for whoever. Young-ish individual is what I just heard. Young-ish individual. So it's a young-ish individual that's about to come down with this severe respiratory illness. It's about to take them by surprise. Now, you might watch this, we normally know. You know what I automatically think of when I hear a respiratory illness, but it really could be any respiratory illness. It could possibly be COVID. It could be flu. It could be ARDS. It could be any respiratory illness. But I heard severe respiratory illness, so it's gonna come quick and take them by surprise. And I heard young-ish individual. So young-ish, I mean, you take that how that resonates. But for me personally, I think that sorry, my neighbor was out there talking to some friends. I think of like 35 to 55 is what I think of, young-ish. But you take it how it resonates in your own life. Or 30 to 55. You know, 30 to 55, 35 to 55, you take it how it resonates. Fifth, God, we've been getting the throat chakra out a lot lately. Fifth chakra, Archangel Gabriel, man holding a heart. Financial constraints. Fifth chakra, Archangel Gabriel is the throat chakra. You know, it's third time this week I think I've gotten this out. Use your throat chakra. It's there for a reason. That's what I just freaking heard. Use your throat chakra. It's there for a reason. Apparently somebody needs to hear that. Just saying. Holy crap. That's literally what I just heard, the spirit message. I heard use your throat chakra. It's there for a reason. So use your voice. And, you know, you notice his throat is blue. The esophagus is blue. That denotes the fifth chakra, which is the throat chakra. And then, you know, it's kind of like the Little Mermaid. Oh, you know, the little bubble. She gets to sing. Oh, like that. That's what reminds me of with the bubble. But it's just denoting truth, honesty, and clarity is what that's trying to denote around, through his throat chakra. And the color for the chakra is blue. That's why it's blue. But I heard someone has, you know, use your throat chakra, is there for a reason, basically. So you need to use your throat chakra, but you need to spout truth, honesty, and clarity through it. Because that's when the throat chakra is open. When it is closed, there's lies, manipulation, and drama and craziness. So obviously you want to use your throat chakra being open, spouting truth, honesty, and clarity. Just saying. Give you a little entertainment while we... By the way, I want to say, real quick, this is a little off note, but I was watching, what is her name? If anybody wants to look her up, if you're interested in, like, makeup tutorials, which I'm not, you know, y'all see me every day. I don't do makeup unless I go out and really want to look nice. I'm not against makeup. I think makeup is wonderful. It's just not me. But I was scrolling through yesterday. I think her name is Bailey, but I'm about to look it up. She's wonderful. She does makeup tutorials. And I didn't even click on it for the makeup tutorial at all. Actually, I clicked on it because of the title. It was Murder, Mystery, and Makeup. And she started doing her makeup, and I was like, what the crap? It's a makeup tutorial. But the story she was telling, it was these old-timey, like real-time, old-timey stories. It's a story I was listening to, not her doing her makeup, but her makeup was wonderful. But if anybody's interested in her, let me... see if I can find her. I had her posted on my Facebook. Okay. Hold on. Maybe I can find her quick. She was wonderful, though. And she told the story, so, like, she has a lot of pizzazz, and she does a wonderful job at makeup, too. But it's a story. And then I looked up, I watched two of them. I looked up one of them and it was true. Hold on. Good Lord. Sorry, y'all. My phone is so slow.
So at this time...
Bailey's Sarian.
Hundreds of men in the
So, if you're interested in her, her name is Bailey Sarian, B-A-I-L-E-Y, and then her last name is S-A-R-I-A-N. It's Murder, Mystery, and Makeup is what it's called. She's freaking fantastic, and I love her tats. Just saying.
Okay.
Man holding a heart. News of wild sex parties is spreading in a certain community like wildfire. Whoa, that's what I just heard. News of wild sex parties in the past, I heard, is spreading in a certain community like wildfire. That's what I just heard. So somebody apparently has had some, like, threesome parties in the past, or what are they called? Swinger parties in the past. I heard it's really spreading in a certain community like wildfire. And so are respiratory cases. Putting two and two together. I heard, and so are respiratory cases. I'm assuming in the same community. And then I heard right after that, putting two and two together. So, okay, so an increase in respiratory cases and these, where I'm assuming where these wild sex parties took place in the same community. And that's putting two and two together, meaning obviously there might be a reason why there's a severe increase in respiratory cases in that one community, obviously because of the increase in crazy behavior from the past, i.e. wild swinger crazy sex parties. I mean, yeah, that's two and two for sure. Because remember my Sodom and Gomorrah comparison reading the other day? And people were wondering why Corona is increasing, which there are factual reasons why Corona is increasing. But I do think a lot of it has to do with like a Sodom and Gomorrah kind of thing. For me personally, I really do. People wonder why Corona is happening. Well, you know, people wonder why Sodom and Gomorrah happened back in the day too. But if you look back and you read the story, you can see it very clearly. But once you're living in the moment, it's a little different to kind of see it as you're living in the moment. But everybody's living in this moment right now. But you're not going to, people that are going to be alive 200 years from now, imagine what they're going to look and see. Just saying. And they're going to see, apparently, an increase in respiratory cases in this one particular community or communities, however this resonates. And apparently, there's been wild swinger crazy sex parties in this one particular community or communities, too. Just saying. So, is it a Sodom and Gomorrah 2 times 2? Just saying. Man holding a heart. Someone is very ready to get out of a toxic situation they put themselves into. Masculine energy is what I just heard. Someone is very ready to get out of a toxic situation I heard that they put themselves into, and it's a masculine energy. So from what I take from this is it sounds like this masculine energy got themselves and their partner involved in wild sex parties in the past, like wild swinger sex parties. And it sounds like it turned around and backfired on them. It sounds like it did in a huge way. This masculine energy wants to get out of it, but it sounds like the feminine energy is all about the life. This is exactly what it sounds like. But you take it how it resonates. Absolutely. They are very hooked to one particular penis. Oh, God. I heard, yes, they are very hooked to one particular penis. I swear to God, that's what I heard. You cannot make this shit up. Okay, so apparently this masculine energy wants to get out of the life, out of the swinging life, out of the sex swinger party life. But the partner is apparently, I heard from spirit, I swear to God, attached to one particular penis. So they're either attached to, obviously, the way the penis feels inside of them, or they are attached to the person. But I heard from Spirit one particular penis. So I'm thinking it might be the phallic item of the person and not so much the person. Because you can have great sex with somebody and it not be your twin flame by any stretch. You just like their size, you like their length, you like phallically them from a phallic perspective. I'm not trying to be dirty or nasty, but I'm for real, for real. That's what it sounds like, that this feminine energy uses this other masculine energy for sex because she likes the way it feels inside of her, and not the person. She likes the sex. That's exactly what it sounds like. Financial constraints. Someone is extremely embarrassed that they even got themselves involved in this to begin with. They don't even like going in public anymore. Okay, I heard someone is extremely embarrassed that they got themselves involved with this to begin with. They don't even like going in public anymore. So it could be the masculine energy that wants to get out of this. I don't think it's the feminine energy because the feminine energy seems all about this life. I mean, I'm for real, for real. I heard she's attached to one particular penis, so she likes one of them. For sure, more than all the others. But I think it's the penis and not the person. And she seems all about it. But it might be that masculine energy that's sounds like legally attached to this person. So it might be the husband. Yeah. I think it's the masculine energy. But I heard someone is extremely embarrassed. They even got themselves involved in this. And they don't even like going in public. Family members of the feminine energy and the masculine energy. Okay, I heard family members of the feminine energy and the masculine energy. So, yeah, I mean, but what I don't get is why you don't use your freaking throat chakra and say something. Your wife is like hoes or us over here. You need to say something. I mean, because that negatively looks bad and down upon you. I mean, she's like hoes or us times about 100. And she, I heard she likes the penis. I didn't hear she likes the person. I didn't hear she likes their personality or their smile or the way that they make her feel. Not down in the nether regions, if you know what I mean. I mean, emotionally. I mean, I heard she likes the penis. So she's all about the D. I mean, I'm not trying to be nasty, but I'm for real about this. Somebody is married to a hoe. And I'm just being straight up. Somebody's straight up married to a hoe. And it's a feminine hoe. There can be male hoes too. But in this reading, it is a feminine hoe. For real. Someone's about to have a huge wake-up call. That's what I just heard. Someone's about to have a huge wake-up call. Well, I mean, good, but I mean, I'm straight. I mean, I from the messages and the cards, that's straight up the truth. You're married to a hoe, a feminine hoe. And there be masculine hoes too. But you're married to a feminine hoe. The masculine energy has gained weight and they really feel, have low self-esteem. But they really need to speak up. Okay, I heard the masculine energy that is married to this feminine hoe. Basically, and I hate to be nasty about it, but it's the truth, for real. I heard has gained a lot of weight, and so they have low self-esteem, so they feel like they can't speak up. But we heard from Spirit earlier, you need to use your throat chakra, buddy, masculine buddy boy energy, and you need to say something because apparently you're so embarrassed you don't want to go out in public because your wife, and I think it's a wife in here, is just spreading her legs like nobody's business. It's like hoes or us up in here. Business is open. I wonder if she gets paid for it. I mean, I'm just saying. But I heard she's attached to one particular penis. sorry, but it's a little funny. I mean, just saying. I mean, not funny in the real 3D. If it was one of my friends or a coworker, I'd be like, what the hell's wrong with you? You know, dude, what's up? Just saying. But just hearing it, the messages in these cards is a little funny, but I'm sure it's not in the real 3D. But, yeah. The masculine energy really needs to do something legally about this and soon. It really will put you in more financial constraints, but it will be worth it in the end, is what I just heard. Okay, I heard the masculine energy is really going to do, needs to do something about this. It will put you in financial constraints now, but it will be the best thing you ever did, basically. And we have financial constraints, so that would make complete sense. But I heard earlier message, a spirit message in here at the very beginning, that someone's about to get evidence the legal way. So, and it sounds like you're married to this person in here. Masculine energy, I think this is for masculine energy, so I'm speaking to the masculine energy. Masculine energy, I think you're married to this feminine energy, so I will speak to you. Basically, her from spirit, you need to legally do something about it, meaning you probably need to divorce this hoe. She's ruining your name and your reputation and your family name. God, I hope you don't have children, but you might. I mean, I'm just saying, with this hoe. I mean, I hate to say that, but it's true. I mean, for real. She's a hoe. She's a hoe. You ever heard that song? She's a hoe. Just saying. But yeah. I mean, you need to do something legally about this. Because you're attached to her in some type of way. I think it is through marriage. I'm sure you're not her guardian. If you were her guardian, you were able to control everything she could do. I don't think that's it. I think you're her husband. You need to legally do something about this. Get yourself out of that shit. Cut it off. Cut it off. Find somebody that will only spread their legs for you. Just saying. So much better that way. But yeah. This is just nasty. But I heard spirit message in here earlier that you were going to start doing something about it. And thank God you are. Thank God you are. Because this is just a big old hot mess. This is Hot Mess Express. For real, for real. I'll show you the cards one more time. And I'm serious. That song, who sings that song? It's like ringing in my head now. She's a hoe. She's a hoe. For real, for real. That's, I mean, y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all know what song I'm talking about. Who sings that song? Let me see if I can find out. We got to leave in 10 minutes. Let me see if I can find you that song real quick. But whoever this is for, you, as looks like you agreed to sex parties. Excuse me. You agreed, it sounds like, to sex parties in the past. Like swinger parties or some swinger parties. That's sex parties. So it sounds like you agreed to sex parties, aka swinger parties, in the past. But it has come around and backfired on you in a huge way. But it sounds like you want to get out, and she still wants to do it. Now, it might be because possibly she's getting paid for it, or she's just addicted to that one particular penis. Oh, yeah, song by Mr. Vegas. I didn't know that's who sang that. She's a Hoe, song by Mr. Vegas. Let me see if I can play it. No, that's not the one I was thinking of. That's not it. Just saying. That's not it. Ah, might be Ludacris. Hold on. I love some Ludacris, by the way, just saying. I know I don't look like I do, and I'm actually a rock gal, for real, but I like Ludacris. Just listen for a minute. He said hoes on layer. Just saying.
Oh,
video. It's pretty funny. It's almost over. That's the one I was thinking about. And that's Ludacris Ho. If anybody wants to go back and Google that, just saying. But that's exactly what it reminds me of, for real. And really, do you want to be married and known to be married to somebody like that? I mean, just for real, we're back to reality now. I'm serious. Because that's, when I was first hearing the messages and looking at the cards, that's exactly the song that popped in my head. And then when we really see the video and hear the song, is that really who you want to be attached to? I don't think so, because I heard a lot of you guys, masculine energies, don't even want to go out in public because you're ashamed by this. And yeah, I would be too. I mean, nobody wants to be married to somebody like that. I mean, and just, I'm for real, for real. And I heard somebody's about to have a huge wake-up call. Thank God for that, because ew, that is just, I mean, it's one thing, it's, you know, fun and games or whatever, to watch the video and to laugh and, you know, you know, if it's not really happening to you in real 3D time world. But if it is, that's a whole different story. And obviously it is happening, I think, possibly to several masculine energies. So I hope you take some action on this masculine energy. I think this reading is for you, for real, for real, for real. Somebody that is married to a hoe. And I hate to say it like that, but it's true, for real, for real, for real. All right, I hope this helped, for real, for real, for real. Donation, super duper greatly appreciated. The link is working. It's in Hyper Sister 05. It's in the description box below. All donations, super duper greatly appreciated. They truly, truly are. I get the notifications when you send donations. So, just saying. All right. That's it. Hope this helped, for real, for real. I would say please let me know, but this is just horrible. Unless you want to send me a private email. Because this is real life for somebody. And this is pretty nasty and serious. And I do truly think somebody's wife is truly like that. I mean, I really do. And that's... Ooh. So if you want to send me a private email, you're welcome to. All right. I'll see you guys later. Namaste.